welcome to Claymont High School as we bring you high school wrestling between the Claymont Mustangs and the New Philadelphia Quakers. I'm Scott Robinson along with Rick Cole. And Rick, we saw Claymont last week and they had a pretty good match involving the Dover Tornadoes. Now tonight they've got the New Philadelphia Quakers, and certainly this is a little bit different ball game.
Yeah, it's always a great crosstown rivalry between Claymont and New Philly. It's what makes the wrestling real exciting around here. Claymont, a little bit younger this year than what they're accustomed to, a lot more underclassmen. New Philly's got some upperclassmen, so it'll probably balance out. I think Claymont probably will have the upper hand in the lower weights, and probably Philly more so in the upper weights.
All right, we'll come back. We'll talk to both coaches in just a moment. So stay with us to our pre-match show here from Ferris Financial on TV2 Sports.
Relax, Carlos. With McDonald's, you can afford to win them both over.
Now you can pick up a Big Mac Extra Value meal with fries and a Coke for just $3.99. So there's plenty of McDonald's love to go around.
WJER and TV2 would like to introduce you to a new website, WJERTV2.com, where you can watch exciting high school football, soccer, and volleyball replays from TV2 Sports on your home computer, smartphone, or tablet. Also watch the latest episodes of TV2's original programming, Sports Talk, The Garden Girl, The Not-So-Shy Chef, Off the Record, and Medical Minutes, as well as catch up on local community news and search for local businesses. So make sure to check out the new WJERTV2.com community website, where everything's local.
In the nation, it's not always pretty. But add brand new belongings from Nationwide Insurance, and we'll replace destroyed or stolen items with brand new versions. We take care of the heat, so you don't get burned. Just another way we put members first, because we don't have shareholders. Join the nation.
Nationwide is on your side.
Tell me, are you confident in your financial game plan? Hello, I'm Matt Ferris, president of Ferris Financial. If you're like most people, you've probably spent a lot of time talking about getting your financial affairs to order, but for some reason, the game plan has never come together. At Ferris Financial, we're here to help you solidify your personal, business, and estate planning goals so that we can build a winning game plan together and help you achieve peace of mind. Please call us at 330-321-1413. Ferris Financial, helping you plan, protect, and prosper.
The moment they hand over the keys, the day a house becomes a home, the feeling when your dream becomes a reality, these are the moments you'll remember forever. At People's Bank, our difference is providing you financial peace of mind and confidence. By asking the right questions and working with you, we earn your business. We know your family and understand your story. People's Bank, working together, building success.
Tonight's sporting event is brought to you in part by Integrity Auto Sales, located at 1025 West High Avenue in New Philadelphia. Looking for a hot buy on a new car? To warm up your winter, give Integrity Auto a call at 330-308-9378, where every sale is made with Integrity. Mention this ad and receive a $100 gas card with any sale. Bag's Sports Pub, located at 136 East Main Street in Sugar Creek. Next time you're in the Sugar Creek area, be sure to check out Bag's Sports Pub, where good friends, food, and spirits come together. Bernays Italian Deli and Cafe, located at 222 Logan Street in Denison, serving the tastiest homemade food around with daily specials and to die for desserts. Bernays Italian Deli and Cafe. Come for lunch and leave as a friend. Peter's Tire and Auto Service, located at 135 North Water Street in downtown Yorksville. Peter's Tire and Auto is a full-service shop offering a wide range of automotive services and is a certified NAPA Auto Care Center. Allman Incorporated, You know them as A&M Service Center, located at 1172 Tuscarora Avenue Northwest in New Philadelphia. Tis the season. If you know your car needs servicing soon, keep in mind our holiday hours. Schedule your appointment with A&M Service Center by calling 330-343-3013 this week to help you stay on schedule for your holiday travel. Twin City Pharmacy and Gift Shop, located at 21 Grant Street in Denison. Twin City Pharmacy and Gift Shop has been in existence for over 50 years, serving not only the needs of Denison and Uhrichsville customers, but customers from coast to coast. Open Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m., and Saturday, 9 a.m. to 3 p.m., and closed on Sundays.
Good evening. This is Rick Cole with TV2. Here with Coach Tokinen, head coach of the Claymont Mustangs. We're about to watch the Mustangs wrestle against New Philadelphia. And Coach Tokinen, this year your team's a little bit younger. Tell us how your position for tonight in your matchups.
Well, I like the age of our team, Ricky. It's just that the inexperience. You know, we lost 10 state wrestlers this past year, and I give a lot of credit to these guys that are wrestling tonight. Mm-hmm. Who stuck it out and stuck behind them and worked hard. But experience is a huge thing. And with the large crowd tonight that we're having, we really need our kids to perform under the gun.
Yeah, and I love this crosstown rivalry every year, year in and year out, Claymont versus Philly. It's one the fans enjoy, we all enjoy it. We look forward to a great evening.
Right, you know, there's nothing better than hometown rivalry, and Indian Valley, Dover, Philly are great matches for us and hopefully for the communities.
Well, good luck tonight, Coach.
Thank you.
If a child walks into our bank every month and deposits a dollar a day into their savings account, it'll make a real difference in their wallet when they grow up. Interest on savings that compounds into money earning more money on more money over time really adds up. Save with us and watch your money grow right alongside of your child or grandchild. First National Bank of Denison, member FDIC. It's all about you.
My name is Danielle. I'm a 2000 graduate from Buckeye Career Center Health Occupation Program, which helped me get my job here at Union Hospital on the pediatric floor as a registered nurse.
We are Buckeye Career Center graduates.
Buckeye Career Center helped my family get the training and education they needed to start our careers.
We're Buckeye Career Center graduates.
I'm Rod. Upon graduation of Buckeye Career Center, they helped me find a job.
Adults who return to Buckeye Career Center to continue their education usually have one goal in mind. They want the opportunity for a better job. The fact is, adult education programs at Buckeye Career Center are less expensive and provide greater opportunities for job placement following graduation. It's your future. Get the facts. Buckeye Career Center. We put people to work. Find out more about your future at buckeyecareercenter.org.
WJER and TV2 would like to introduce you to a new website, WJERTV2.com, where you can watch exciting high school football, soccer, and volleyball replays from TV2 Sports on your home computer, smartphone, or tablet. Also watch the latest episodes of TV2's original programming, Sports Talk, The Garden Girl, The Not-So-Shy Chef, Off the Record, and Medical Minutes, as well as catch up on local community news and search for local businesses. So make sure to check out the new WJERTV2.com community website, where everything's local.
Myers & Miller Podiatry provides complete foot and ankle care to patients of all ages. The practice was established in 2000 by Dr. Adam Myers and has grown to include Dr. Andy Miller in 2007 and most recently Dr. Jason Backage in 2010. Our core values of respect and honesty are the basis for how we manage our practice, and we have grown by building relationships with our patients in order to better serve their needs. Myers & Miller Podiatry serves Tuscarora and Holmes County with offices in Dover, Sugar Creek, Newcomerstown, and Millersburg. Let's get started building our relationship.
Government officials, business leaders, volunteers, and much more. You'll hear it all here on TV2 Profiles, exclusively on TV2. Hi, I'm your host, Cheyenne Carroll, and join me as I interview the Tuscarawas Valley's leading women. You can visit WJERTV2.com for show episodes and details.
Welcome back to our pre-match show brought to you by Ferris Financial. And joining us on this segment is Dave Clarkson, the head coach of the New Philadelphia Quakers. And Coach, Claymont's always a tough battle, but certainly I think you feel there are some strengths of your team in this match tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. This is always a quality team. This is a great place to wrestle. And we need to get better tonight, you know, and that's where our focus is. We've had a long layoff since the Hudson Invitational before Christmas break, so we got to get our legs under us quick and improve tonight. That's where the focus is at.
When you look at the weight classes, what do you think some of your strengths are going to be?
You know, our middle to uppers, we have a lot of great experience there. We're looking for, you know, tough matches at 220. You know, Jeff Burden has a very good wrestler tonight that he needs to wrestle well against and make a statement. And we have a lot of, you know, crucial matches in the upper weights tonight.
Yeah, so you're going to, as always, Claymont's a tough opponent. It's a great atmosphere. How much does the atmosphere play into this? I mean, this place is going to get rocking and rolling here in a little while.
Oh, yeah, it's a great program, great atmosphere. This is we love to be here, and it's exciting for the kids, and we're looking forward to it.
All right, well, good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Head coach Dave Clarkson of the New Philadelphia Quakers. That's been our pre-match show brought to you by Ferris Financial. We'll come back with the start of our match in a moment right after this on TV2 Sports.
Omni Orthopedics comprehensive programs provide early diagnosis and successful treatment for every musculoskeletal problem. With more than 30 years of orthopedic experience, their physicians offer patient-centered treatment for all ages. From evaluation to rehabilitation, your treatment plan is designed around your needs. Omni Orthopedics specializes in sports medicine, the spine, physical medicine and rehabilitation, foot and ankle, and hand surgery. If pain makes activities like climbing stairs, standing or walking a challenge, turn to the home team at Omni Orthopedics. Their mission is to provide you with the highest quality and most advanced orthopedic services so you can get back in the game. Located in the Oxford Medical Arts Building, Omni offers a full service facility, including digital x-ray and physical therapy. So there's no need to travel when quality care is so close to home. Omni Orthopedics, setting the standard in orthopedic care.
Relax, Carlos. With McDonald's, you can afford to win them both over.
Now you can pick up a Big Mac Extra Value meal with fries and a Coke for just $3.99. So there's plenty of McDonald's love to go around.
Tell me, are you confident in your financial game plan? Hello, I'm Matt Ferris, president of Ferris Financial. If you're like most people, you've probably spent a lot of time talking about getting your financial affairs to order, but for some reason, the game plan has never come together. At Ferris Financial, we're here to help you solidify your personal, business, and estate planning goals so that we can build a winning game plan together and help you achieve peace of mind. Please call us at 330-321-1413. Ferris Financial, helping you plan, protect, and prosper.
The moment they hand over the keys, the day a house becomes a home, the feeling when your dream becomes a reality, these are the moments you'll remember forever. At People's Bank, our difference is providing you financial peace of mind and confidence. By asking the right questions and working with you, we earn your business. We know your family and understand your story. People's Bank, working together, building success.
And we're back as we get ready to go here with our first match, starting at the 132-pound weight class for Claymont, Chandler Golick, and for New Philadelphia, Logan Dusenberry. Scott Robinson and Rick Cole with you. And Rick, take it away.
Yeah, good evening, Scott. Should be a great match tonight. Great crosstown rivalry. Contrast in physiques here. Logan, tall, lanky fella. Golick, much shorter. Nice shot by Dusenberry. Good single leg. He's got to watch that splatel. Golick fighting that off nice. In a scramble position. That should be a takedown. No! I thought there was a takedown there, but official called that off. Takedown for Claymont. Out of bounds.
So it is 2-0. Chandler Golick leading Logan Dusenberry.
That's a real nice single leg shot by Dusenberry. Golick did a nice job fighting that off. Looking for a tilt. No points, no back points there. Dusenberry's got to start coming up out of there, get some hand control. Golick digging both boots in there. This could be tough. He's going to try to stretch him out there, elongate him. Ref will stop that in a minute. Oh, okay. And that will wear you out, Scott, when the guy's on top of you with both legs in, cranking on that half. That's makes for a long period. And the referee may stop that for potentially dangerous because of his shoulder starting to get in a very awkward position there.
That does not look too comfortable, that's for sure.
Logan fought that off real nice.
30 seconds to go here in the first period of our first match.
Golick doing a nice job with the legs in. Now, Dusenberry, he's got to move off that bottom because if Golick gets the boots in, he'll put some more punishment on him. No back points there.
And that's the end of the first period. 2-0. Golick leading Dusenberry as we get ready to go to the second period here in our first match, the 132-pound weight class.
Let's see how Dusenberry does on top here. Bottom was not a great position for him.
Where do you see the key matches tonight?
Yeah, I see them at that 152 match will be critical. In these lightweights here, these first four weight classes, New Philly has got to compete, not give up bonus points.
So it is 4-0 now. Chandler Golick getting a couple of points there.
I'm looking forward to that 145 match as well, Johnny Riker against Solomon Peters. That'll be a fine match. Golick still working that crossbody ride. Dusenberry. Doing what? There you go. He's got to elevate that leg. Keep slipping your hips. Out the back door. Nice job. Real nice.
So two for Dusenberry, and it's 4-2. Golick leading Logan Dusenberry here.
Dusenberry finally decided he wasn't going to stay down there any longer.
Minute 15 to go here in this second period.
Reverse. For Golick.
6-2. Golick with the lead over Dusenberry.
Golick getting close to some back points, but you got to hold him there for at least a two count. Golick going to work an arm bar here on that right side. And he lost it.
44 seconds to go here. Second period.
Dusenberry got to peel those hands. Get right back up, right back up. Golick doing a nice job. He likes those boots, and he knows how to punish with them. Golic working that cross body with a power half here.
14 seconds to go here, second period.
We'll see what Coach Tokanen puts Golic in the third period because he'll have choice.
6-2. Chandler Golic with the lead over Logan Dusenberry as we go to the third period of action.
I think Dusenberry, yeah, there you go, should go on his feet because he had a real nice shot that first period. And indeed, Coach Clarkson told Dusenberry go neutral, which and gives a point.
Right,
to
a
Golic.
Point goes to Golic, so it'll be 7-2.
Dusenberry really needs to get on his offense here. Takedown will definitely make this more heated contest between them. Yeah.
Minute 30 to go here, 7-2. Golic leading Dusenberry.
Nice shot by Golic and a nice counter by Dusenberry. Logan's got to kick it into another gear here. They got to get out of that ear-to-ear tie-up. Just got to go.
Down to the final minute. Dusenberry's got to try and make something happen here.
Yeah, Golic doesn't need to push it here, but Dusenberry needs to go. I'm sure Coach Tokanen would like to see some bonus points here if Golic can get a takedown.
Looks like they're happy just to kind of stalemate it out
here.
Yeah,
which won't make either coach happy. And Dusenberry needs to get a 5-point takedown real quick here.
So two more points for Chandler Golic with 8 seconds to go.
Golic just, I think, a little physically too strong. But a nice match for both wrestlers. Good job.
So 9-2, the first match goes to Chandler Golic of the Mustangs. And that puts the team total at 3-0 here. So 38 pounds, it'll be Cade Bates for New Philadelphia and Hunter Miles for the Claymont Mustangs.
And like most Claymont matches, you don't want them to get on a roll because it's like a snowball coming at you downhill.
I think Coach Tokanen was worried about these matches in the mid to upper weight levels that he thought New Philadelphia may score some points there.
Yeah, if New Philly wants to make a match of this, they've got to be strong and win three or four of these middleweights. Bates is wanting to set up a headlock here. He's got it locked up, but Hunter Miles, he knows he can feel that coming, so he backed out of that.
Minute to go
nice
here,
shot.
First period.
Yeah, nice. Yeah, Bates likes upper body throws, and that was a beautiful one, lateral drop. That'll be 2 points for a takedown, and then I think two back points. So, and I have a hunch Coach Clarkson is going to tell him to kick him out.
Well, the score right now, 4-0. Cade Bates with the lead. 33 seconds to go here in the first period.
Let's see what Bates does. Yeah. He wants to go back on his feet. So Bates the one, does. And
so the 1 point going to Miles here on the release.
And so Bates is going to look for another throw.
4-1.
And sometimes the best time to hit a throw is when your opponent shoots on you, and as they're backing out, then you can throw them.
3 seconds to go. 2-1. And that's it for the first period of action. 4-1, Cade Bates leading Hunter Miles.
Good first move by Miles. Excellent. Excellent explosion on the bottom. That's exactly how you get out of there. Good job.
So a point for Hunter Miles, making it 4-2.
Single leg shot by Miles. Bates trying to fight it off. Yeah, good job.
2 points for Miles, making it 4-4.
Bates needs to know where he's wrestling right down the edge and get a fresh start.
So they'll head back to the center with 1:03 to go here in the second period. 4-4 the score between Bates and Miles.
Let's see how Bates, see if he can come up like the Claymont wrestler did. Yeah, nice job. Both guys, nice job on the bottom. Now, as soon as he hits, he needs to go. As soon as he gets picked up and put down on the mat, he needs to keep moving. He's got to peel the hands. There you go. This is where Coach Clarkson wants his wrestler on the feet.
Point for Bates. It's 5-4 for the new Philadelphia wrestler.
Nice head shuck. Oh, he wants that upper body. Yeah. Yeah, that's exactly what Bates wants. Bates wants to lock him up upper body and work on his throws. Miles needs to just stay on his low leg shots. Like that. Now he's got to be careful. He's got to be careful here. Oh. Bates, he forced the throw there that was not there. So takedown and 2 back points for Miles to really open up that lead 10-5.
So it's 10-5 Miles over Bates. And that's the end of the second period. We'll get ready to go here with the third period, 10-5. And boy, that was a great period for Hunter Miles.
It was. Bates, he tried to force that upper body throw, and it was not there. But somebody who does a lot of throws, they're always in the match, and they can throw it any time. So we'll see how this third period plays out. I think Coach Slarb is perhaps checking the if there's back points at all on that last takedown. And in this match, every point needs to be contested.
So we've got a little bit of a debate here.
Yeah, I think Philly thinks it should be 9-5. But I do believe the accurate score is 10-5.
Looks like we're ready to go, and the 10-5 may in fact be the correct score.
All right, Bates needs to fire up out of there. Nice stand up. Miles going to try to return him to the mat, and now he needs to come right back up, but he doesn't. As soon as you hit the mat, you need to fire right back up. Miles doing a nice job, riding tough.
Minute 35 to go here, third period. 10-5. Miles leading Bates.
Bates needs to have some mat awareness. He's now Miles, he'll be quite content just to ride him out there. Yeah, stalling on top.
Minute 5 to go here in this 138-pound match. Hunter Miles with the upper hand here early in this third period.
Bates needs to keep moving. Miles has to be careful because he may get hit for stalling because he's riding parallel.
Yeah, he's gotten a warning already.
Yeah. But Bates needs to give the referee reason to call him, to call Miles for stalling.
26 seconds to go. Looks like the Mustangs are going to pick up a second win in a row here. And Miles is going to pick up the victory. As the our score was 10-5, and either way, it's a win for Miles. Solomon Peters at 145 for the Claymont Mustangs. John Riker for the New Philadelphia Quakers.
Phillies. New Phillies got to get on the board here. They need a win at this weight class. Riker's been wrestling since the youth league.
Two points for Solomon Peters. He leads it early.
Nice switch for Riker. Nice reversal.
And Riker with 2 points there. So it's 2-2 with a minute 26 to go here in the first period.
Riker's got an arm bar in. He needs to work that arm bar. He's running out of territory there. There's a nice shot of that arm bar he's got on that left side. Needs to drive straight ahead and out of bounds.
So when he's got that arm bar, what's the intent or what's his next move once he gets that?
What you want to do is drive that arm bar. You want to drive this shoulder right into the guy's ear, and then that will turn him. That'll turn him every time. But you want to drive more to 12 o'clock as opposed to 3 o'clock. I'm sure he's probably going to look for that armbar again.
48 seconds to go here in the first period of this 145-pound match.
Peters needs to get his head up off the mat and start building a base there because he's going to get hit for a stalling call here in a minute. Riker with that half. He's got to pick him up and put him down. He's got a reversal and he's going to get some back points here.
And it's a pin.
I'm not sure. I thought time ran out.
I think it's a pin. I think it's close.
Yeah. What's he saying here? Time? Yeah.
Yep.
It was good.
So yeah. Pin by Solomon Peters. In the first period. Makes it 12-0. Next up, at the 152-pound weight class, Rex Peters, and then Corbin Croft for the New Philadelphia Quakers. Mustangs off to a good start. They lead it 12-0 as a team.
Yeah, that one was right at the buzzer. So far, both look pretty evenly matched.
Minute 31 to go here in the first period. Scott Robinson and Rick Cole with you here on TV2 Sports.
Contact problem there. Peters missed most of his junior year last year with a pretty serious foot injury, but he's come back real nice. Nice single leg. Corbin working that off of the whizzer.
55 seconds to go here. First period of the 152-pound weight class. Rex Peters for Claymont. Corbin Croft for New Philadelphia.
Both guys going at it real, pretty aggressive. Somebody needs to tee off here and get a good shot. On that double leg. Croft needs to keep his hips down. Out of bounds.
This match, a lot of it's been off the mat instead of in the center of the ring.
You never want to go into that second period with a 0-0 score. You want to be up. You want to have an edge. But that's what we're going to do, go 0-0. Claymont chooses down.
Ready for the second 2 minutes here. 0-0 the score between Rex Peters and Corbin Croft. Look like they're pretty evenly matched, Rick.
Yeah, they are. Their styles are very similar. Nice switch by Peters. Nicely done. I thought there was a reversal there, but referee doesn't think so. So Peters will stay in the down position. And he does a nice job moving off the whistle. He's moving right now, working that switch again. Croft needs to step over to stop that switch, but Peters is still working to come behind. And let's see, he's close to getting that reversal. Croft is hanging on to that leg. If he lets go, that Peters will come on around. Peters has got to get his hips around another stalemate. Okay. Peters doing a real nice job on the bottom.
Minute 13 to go here in the second period. No score for Croft or Peters.
Yeah, I think Coach Schlarb wanted Croft to get him on his feet because Peters was awful close on several occasions to getting a reversal there.
So Peters picks up the first point of the match.
You can't do those little half shots. That won't get you anywhere. Oh, he's got a, that's trouble. Couldn't quite see what happened there, but they're both still in the neutral position.
Forty seconds to go here, second period. 1-0, Rex Peters with the lead.
Peters with a nice shuck there to a single leg. He's got to elevate that. Not yet. I think that's two. No. Surely that's a takedown. There it is.
So it's 3-0. Peters with the lead over Croft. And that's the end of the second period. It's 3-0. Peters leading Croft. Team score, it's Claymont 12, New Philadelphia 0.
Croft still in a good position here. If he can score out of the escape or reversal, he's right back in it. Peters riding him tough. Croft needs to base up and get busy there.
Minute 30 to go here, third period. 3-0, Peters leading Croft in our 152-pound weight class match.
And the official's going to hit one of them for stalling. I'm not sure who he's going to call. Sometimes when you're on the bottom, Scott, you got to combine a couple of moves. You just can't do one move and stop. See if he can put together a nice series here for Croft. Tried a Granby roll there, but didn't get his hips cleared. Peters with that crossbody ride. Yeah, I think the official's going to have to call somebody for stalling here.
45 seconds to go in the match.
Yeah. And he called the Claymont wrestler.
So Rex Again, Peters, stalling call.
Yeah, the ref, what he's looking for is if the top wrestler's hips are not out to the side, they'll call the top man for stalling. Working the tilt. Peter's trying to tilt.
Down to 25 seconds here in the third period. Peter's leading it 3-0.
He's trying to turn his shoulders here with that crossbody ride. Good match.
And that's the end of the match as Rex Peters comes up with a 3-0 win, increasing the lead to 15-0 for the Mustangs. And we're kind of in the area that we thought New Philadelphia might have some chances here at some of these matches.
Yeah, they need to get a few wins here to hope to stay in this match.
So at the 160-pound match, Jorge Raimondo and Justice Avery for Claymont, Raimondo for New Philadelphia. And it's a walkover.
So Clarkson decided not to wrestle Jorge.
I believe that'll make it 21 to nothing, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And now at the 170-pound match, Keaton Heron versus of Claymont versus Logan Ford of New Philadelphia.
I've been looking forward to this match. Should be a real physical match. Nice double leg shot. Nice, by Hare. Oh. No takedown there. Real nice double leg by Heron. By his hair, and I'd get back on that leg attack. I'm sure he will.
Minute 12 to go here, first period of the 170-pound weight class.
There it is. Real nice. Real nice double leg.
2 points for Keaton Heron. Down to 45 seconds to go, first period. Heron with a 2-0 lead.
Ford needs to keep coming up. Oh, out of bounds.
Tables almost got turned
there.
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, Logan Ford must be awful strong to be able to do that. It's pretty impressive. But no change in position.
Down to 28 seconds to go here in the first period. Heron remaining in the lead at 2-0.
Ford needs to come up. Yeah, that does not look good to the official when you're just kind of laying on the bottom there. Of course, Heron is putting a lot of pressure on him. But Ford's got to find an answer to that.
So to the second period we go. 2-0. Keaton Heron with the lead over Logan Ford. Overall, the match stands at 21-0. Claymont with the lead over New Philadelphia.
Nice stand up by Heron. Nice reversal by Heron. Good job.
Heron with the reversal makes it 4-0.
And I'm sure this is where Coach Clarkson did not want to see his team score at this point. Heron working that arm bar. He's got a double arm bar in there. Again, Ford needs to appreciate where he's at near that out-of-bounds circle and find it, because nothing good happens if a guy has an arm bar in on you like that. Referee stopped it for potentially dangerous.
58 seconds to go, second period. Heron up 4-0.
Ford is still in this match if he can get an escape or a reversal here before the end of the period. Got to peel his hands, get right back up.
Mm-hmm.
Ford needs to keep coming up. Up. Heron doing a nice job. He's got that nice arm bar in there, too, now.
21 seconds to go here, second period.
Ford needs to make something happen there. You can't stay on your belly. There's no moves from your belly.
That's the end of the second period. 4-0, Keaton Heron leading over Logan Ford as we go to this third period of action. Claymont with a dominating lead already at 21-0.
Ford needs to get on the attack here. I'm sure Heron wants to give him another steady dose of out of bounds. Another steady dose of a double leg. We'll see here. But Ford's not quitting. He's toe-to-toe with him. He's not thinking about stopping. It looks like Ford wants to go for a front headlock to a go-behind. But again, he's going to run out of territory here. Ford, get behind. Coach
2 points.
Tokenham won't be happy
for
that.
Ford, and it's 4-2.
Ford right back in it. Now he's going to let him up.
They let him up. That's a point for Heron. That makes it 5-2.
Yeah. Conditioning is going to start to play a big role here in this.
Minute to go, third period.
Now if he can score, if he can get behind. Out of bounds. Ford has, he's showing no signs of slowing up here. Nice shot by Herring. Ford, he's setting up a lateral drop. He wants to throw him, but I don't think Heron's gonna be fooled into that. No.
Close to a pin. Well, I don't know. That's pretty tight in there.
Yeah, it sure is.
He had him real close. Now I'm not so sure he can get there.
13 seconds if Ford can survive this here. And I think he is. Oh, wow. That's a strong young man right there to be able to roll off his back.
And 10-2. The score of our match, Keaton Heron picks up the victory. We'll take a break. We'll come back with a 182-pound match in a moment here on TV2 Sports.
My name is Danielle. I'm a 2000 graduate from Buckeye Career Center Health Occupation Program, which helped me get my job here at Union Hospital on the pediatric floor as a registered nurse.
We are Buckeye Career Center graduates.
Buckeye Career Center helped my family get the training and education they needed to start our careers.
We're Buckeye Career Center graduates.
I'm Rod. Upon graduation of Buckeye Career Center, they helped me find a job.
Adults who return to Buckeye Career Center to continue their education usually have one goal in mind. They want the opportunity for a better job. The fact is, adult education programs at Buckeye Career Center are less expensive and provide greater opportunities for job placement following graduation. It's your future. Get the facts. Buckeye Career Center. We put people to work. Find out more about your future at buckeyecareercenter.org.
You can create a lasting legacy with a gift to the Tuscarawas County Community Foundation. It provides a safe, trustworthy, philanthropic choice for your estate planning needs. Through the generosity of area residents, the foundation has been able to provide nearly $5 million in funding for a variety of community projects and student scholarships that have positively impacted each corner of our county. Help your community by making a tax-deductible donation to the Tuscarawas County Community Foundation today.
WJER and TV2 would like to introduce you to a new website, WJERTV2.com, where you can watch exciting high school football, soccer, and volleyball replays from TV2 Sports on your home computer, smartphone, or tablet. Also watch the latest episodes of TV2's original programming, Sports Talk, The Garden Girl, The Not-So-Shy Chef, Off the Record, and Medical Minutes, as well as catch up on local community news and search for local businesses. So make sure to check out the new WJERTV2.com community website where everything's local.
In the nation, it's not always pretty. But add brand new belongings from Nationwide Insurance, and we'll replace destroyed or stolen items with brand new versions. We take care of the heat, so you don't get burned. Just another way we put members first, because we don't have shareholders. Join the nation.
Nationwide is on your side.
As the area's leader in direct-to-garment printing, you won't be surprised by Denison T-Shirt Graphics' huge range of services. Screen printing, banners, engraving, graphic design, and embroidery. They offer just about anything you can imagine, like shirts, mugs, hats, plaques, trophies, and more. They're located right here in New Philadelphia on the South Side and on the web at denisont-shirt.com.
Government officials, business leaders, volunteers, and much more. You'll hear it all here on TV2 Profiles, exclusively on TV2. Hi, I'm your host, Cheyenne Carroll, and join me as I interview the Tuscarawas Valley's leading women. You can visit WJERTV2.com for show episodes and details.
And we're back as we start out with a 182-pound match. Lyle Clark for the Claymont Mustangs and Casey Swinnerman for the New Philadelphia Quakers.
Took a finger in the eye there. And needless to say, this is a must win for the Quakers. Nice slide by Kyle Clark there. That was real nice. But Swinnerman fought that off. Nice single leg shot. Nice takedown by Swinnerman.
2 points for Swinnerman. It's 2-0 here in this first period with a minute 25 to go.
Swinnerman with that head lever. It's going to pop that to a half, yeah. That's tight. He's got a minute to survive this. Close to the out of bounds there. If Clark could bridge a little bit and at this point just find the out of bounds and get a new start.
Boy, how is he keeping his shoulders off the mat?
Yeah, and Swinnerman knows what to do here.
...25-6 now, the team score.
That Lyle Clark is only a freshman. He will be a good one. I'm telling you right now, he will be good.
The 195-pound match now. Tim Zerker for the Mustangs and Xavier Barrow for the New Philadelphia Quakers.
Xavier Barrow from a long line of Barrow brother wrestling family. I don't know if Xavier's the last of the bunch of them or not.
There have been a lot of them.
There has been, yeah. All very talented athletes. In on that single leg. Oh, good job by Zerker fighting that single leg off.
Minute 35 to go here in the first period. Scott Robinson and Rick Cole with you from Claymont High School.
Barra working that front headlock. He's probably going to take it to a shuck by here. Nice job working that front headlock. Stepping over for a takedown.
So Barra with a quick 2 points.
Well, Zerker is not giving up on that leg, but the ref has already given him a takedown, which I'm not sure about that, but I don't have the pinstripes on.
A minute to go here, first period. 25-6, the team score. Claymont leading New Philadelphia.
I think somebody's got a bloody nose here.
Going too smoothly.
Yeah.
You want to stay tuned to TV2 Sports coming up on Friday night. It'll be Coshocton at New Philadelphia. And so that's one of the basketball games coming up here. And we'll have more wrestling coming up on the 24th as the Claymont Mustangs will take on Solon. And then also next Tuesday night, we'll have Dover at Claymont. So a lot of basketball action coming on.
Barrow doing a nice job on top, working the wrist stride. See if he can turn that into a pinning combination. Zerker doing a nice job fighting his hands, coming to his feet. That's the way you do it right there. He got nice hand control, and then there's nothing holding him down, so he's able to come up, get that escape.
Got a point, 2-1.
And this will be a big takedown for somebody here.
22 seconds to go, first period of our 195-pound weight class. Tim Zerker for Claymont, Xavier Barrow for the New Philadelphia Quakers.
Barrow working that two-on-one. Into a single leg, let's see if he can finish up. 5 seconds here. Not quite, good job. Nice shot by Barrow, good defense by Zerker.
And that's the end of the first period. 2-1. Xavier Barrow leading Tim Zerker. So Barrow will be on top here as we get started with the second period.
Barrow riding tough on top. And Zerker needs to find that hand control again. Peel the hands, find the hands, and come up. He's back up to his base, but now he's got to get his hips under him and come up. Now Barrow's got to do something with that right over there. Zerker going to try to peel the hands. Barrow's got to return him. And nice job by Zerker for
and
reversal.
2 points for Zerker, making it 3-2.
He's got a nice half there. That's deep. That's tight. And timeout here for Barrow to get his headgear back on. Zerker was running a real nice wrist and a half there. He should go back to that.
59 seconds to go here in the second period.
Barrow does not want to hang out on the bottom there. So I think Zerker can work him pretty hard. Good match, even match here between these two young men. And let's see what Barrow does here on the bottom, see if he's got a good first move. And he's up to his feet already. He's got to peel the hands. You got to peel the hands, get your hips away. Hips away. Now Zerker's got to return him to the mat. Good job. Oh, and Baro, I couldn't quite see what happened there, but. Yeah, no change. A little bit of a flurry there, but they end up right where they started with Zerker on top and Baro still in the down position.
Second period, 30 seconds to go.
And he's working at half. And he's got that deep. That is a nice. Zerker needs to get out front and commit to that half.
Down to 3 seconds, 2 seconds. And that is going to be it for the second period. 3-2, Zerker leading Baro as we head into this crucial third period.
Baro took neutral, so they're both on their feet. And
what's the advantage there to take neutral?
Well, coach thinks that he's better off trying to get a takedown on Zerker because I don't think he can hold Zerker down, and he can't get out from bottom on Zerker. So I think coach very smartly had Baro go on top. He's got to spin around, get this takedown. He's got to go. Pop your head. Oh, no. Nice job by Zerker.
Zerker with 2 points makes it 5-2.
And this is where Coach Clarkson did not want Baro underneath Zerker.
Minute 10 to go here, third period, 5-2. Zerker leading Baro.
Headgear problem again there. Plenty of time left. Baro can get moving here, and I'm sure Zerker, his goal is not to let him up. Nice first move there. Baro needs to keep coming up. And Zerker setting that arm bar in there real nice there. He's got a half on that other side with the arm bar. Oh. It was a good call. It's potentially dangerous. Baro's left shoulder was in a bad way there. But that was a bad position for Baro to be in. He can't afford to go there again. Because that was almost lights out. Nice first move by Baro. He's got to keep coming up. You got to move. Move.
28 seconds to go.
Yeah, Zerker is an absolute load on top.
All he's got to do is ride him out here for about 10 more seconds.
Yeah.
And this is going to be another victory for the Claymont Mustangs. 5-2, the match score.
That's a match where if they wrestle again, it would be either young man's match. It's a good job by both wrestlers.
Up next, 220 pounds. We build up the
so at the 220-pound match, it's Nate Gray for Claymont and Jeff Verdon for New Philadelphia. This one could be interesting.
Yeah, this will be good.
Three more points to Claymont's total, making it 28-6 for the match.
Nate Gray has a real nice low single leg for a big guy. He hits it real well, even though he hit a nice slide by there. And there it is. Has that low single leg I'm talking about.
2 points there for Nate Gray. So Gray leading it 2-0 here with a minute 38 to go in the first period.
Gray will probably give him a steady diet of those low singles.
And that time Vernon felt that low single coming from Gray.
Two to one, Gray with the lead over Verdon.
Nice slide by.
Gray looks comfortable. Yeah. Verdon, I'm not so sure.
Yeah, I don't think he feels real good on his feet. He needs to be careful tying up with him because Gray's going to hit that slide by again. But what happens is with that low single that Gray has, Verdon will just keep grabbing hold of him, which will set that slide by up you're about to see there. And then when that doesn't work, he'll go back to his low single.
Seconds to go here in the first period of our 220-pound match.
Verdon needs to score off that front headlock. Needs to get him down on the mat. Stalemate.
Down to 16 seconds to go here in the first period. It's a lot of slapping. Don't see much rustling at this point.
Yeah.
6 seconds to go. And that's the end of the first period. We'll go to the second period.
Yeah, it's nice to see two big horses like that get after it. I wouldn't want to be in between them.
No, I don't think so either. That's for sure. 2-1, Nate Gray leading Jeff Verdon.
Two to one.
Coming up following our match, we'll have our Bell Stores match recap. Also name our McDonald's most valuable wrestler for our match as well. Just seems like they can't even get started and they're outside the circle.
Yeah, yeah. They can cover some territory there. If I was Verdon, I'd try to come back up to my feet because he was almost out there. There you go. Right back up. He's doing a good job moving. Gray doing a nice job keeping him down.
A minute 12 to go, second period. Just no rhythm in this match at all.
No. Verdon, it's important he tries to get a point here before this period's up. He's got to peel those hands, get his hips away. Separate your hips. Hips. No escape, no takedown. It's still neutral, still neutral. 1 point. Escape, Verdon.
So we got a 2-2 score. Okay. 50 seconds to go here, second period. 2-2 our score.
I have a hunch conditioning is going to decide this one going into the third period. Gray needs to get back on those leg attacks. He needs to go back to what was working for him in the first period.
Well, they were full of energy in that first period. Things are starting to slow down just a little bit.
Yeah, they keep glancing up at the clock.
9 seconds to go.
Nice shot. Nice shot.
So 3 seconds to go. We're tied at two apiece. Yeah, and that's the end of this second period.
You can't give up a stalling call like
that. Well, now they're going to give
a
point.
You can't do that.
They're going to give a point to Verdon.
Yeah, that's just a mental break on Gray's part. He took 3 steps straight back, and you can't do that.
So the point for stalling, and now we go to the third period here. 3-2, Verdon leading Gray. This 220-pound weight class.
I have a hunt. He probably ought to kick him out and just give him the escape. I think there's that nice low-level shot.
And we're tied at three.
Let's see if Verdon knows what to do with that front headlock. Oh, two.
So Verdon picks up two at 5-3.
Yeah. Coach Clarkson's telling Verdon to go neutral, and which I think is a good idea, because he can't hold Gray down, but I think.
So a point for Gray, so that makes it 5-4.
Yeah. Oh, there's a technical right there, most likely. He's not going to hit anybody with a technical, but he's not going to let that go on. He's got.
Minute 14 to go here in the third period of a contentious match.
I thought Gray jumped the whistle there, but.
Got 2 points, and he's leading it 6-4.
Obviously, he did not, so.
Make it 6-5.
Needs to elevate that foot. Gray hanging on to that foot for dear life. Watch the knee. Yeah, potentially dangerous there. Verdon's knee joint was about to go the wrong way. Good call by the official.
6-5. Gray leading Verdon. 44 seconds to go. It's been contentious at best.
Yeah. Verdon coming up. He's coming up. He's got to get his hips back. Get your hips back. Circle in. He's got to circle in. Got to get behind him. No. 15 seconds.
18 seconds down to 14.
He's got to go behind. There's two.
And that's Verdon leading 7-6.
He just needs to ride tough right there. Good match. Uh-oh. Yeah, Gray needs to just control his emotion there a little bit.
Verdon just beat, I think,
a seventh place state placer last year. So good match for Verdon.
So it's 28-9. And we go to our 285-pound weight class. Jared Aubiel versus Kyle Swinnerman of the Quakers.
That was a nice match. Physical match. Both a couple of big guys going at it. That was nice, nicely wrestled. Good job. And there's a couple of other big fellas getting after it here. You know, year in and year out, I don't know how New Philly does it, but they always put together a good upper weight those last three or four weight classes, they're always pretty deep.
Abiel and Swinnerman just kind of feeling each other out a little bit here, trying to figure out what they can do to get the advantage.
And that's a real popular name in New Philly, that Swinnerman name. There's a long line of wrestlers and football players. It's kind of like the counterpart to the Peters on the Claymont side. And as typically done, you don't see many lower leg attacks here. It's a lot of pushing and shoving. And
50 seconds to go here in the first period.
Now, somebody could throw somebody right here if they would step into it. Let's see here. Yep, there you go.
Guessing that we get to the lower weights, we're going to see the action pick up here in the next match.
Yeah. Now throwing. There you go.
So Swinnerman's got the 2 points, trying to get the pin.
Let's see here. Ooh, he's right on the edge. 15 seconds.
Got the pin for Kyle Swinnerman. We'll take a break. We'll come back with our next match in a moment here on TV2 Sports.
A house becomes a home. The feeling when your dream becomes a reality. These are the moments you'll remember forever. At People's Bank, our difference is providing you financial peace of mind and confidence. By asking the right questions and working with you, we earn your business. We know your family and understand your story. People's Bank, working together, building success.
Tell me, are you confident in your financial game plan? Hello, I'm Matt Ferris, president of Ferris Financial. If you're like most people, you've probably spent a lot of time talking about getting your financial affairs to order, but for some reason, the game plan has never come together. At Ferris Financial, we're here to help you solidify your personal, business, and estate planning goals so that we can build a winning game plan together and help you achieve peace of mind. Please call us at 330-321-1413. Ferris Financial, helping you plan, protect, and prosper.
Myers & Miller Podiatry provides complete foot and ankle care to patients of all ages. The practice was established in 2000 by Dr. Adam Myers and has grown to include Dr. Andy Miller in 2007 and most recently Dr. Jason Backage in 2010. Our core values of respect and honesty are the basis for how we manage our practice, and we have grown by building relationships with our patients in order to better serve their needs. Myers & Miller Podiatry serves Tuscarawas and Holmes County with offices in Dover, Sugar Creek, Newcomerstown, and Millersburg. Let's get started building our relationship.
Relax, Carlos. With McDonald's, you can afford to win them both over.
Now you can pick up a Big Mac Extra Value meal with fries and a Coke for just $3.99. So there's plenty of McDonald's love to go around.
It's all about you. It's all about you.
The more we know you and your financial goals, the more easily we can help you achieve them. Talk to us. Find out why so many of your neighbors come by and talk with our trained loan officers. Around here, it's all about you. First National Bank of Denison, member FDIC. It's all about you.
It's all about you.
Tonight's sporting event is brought to you in part by Integrity Auto Sales, located at 1025 West High Avenue in New Philadelphia. Looking for a hot buy on a new car? To warm up your winter, give Integrity Auto a call at 330-308-9378, where every sale is made with Integrity. Mention this ad and receive a $100 gas card with any sale. Bags Sports Pub, located at 136 East Main Street in Sugar Creek. Next time you're in the Sugar Creek area, be sure to check out Bags Sports Pub, where good friends, food, and spirits come together. Bernays Italian Deli and Cafe, located at 222 Logan Street in Denison. Serving the tastiest homemade food around with daily specials and to die for desserts. Bernays Italian Deli and Cafe. Come for lunch and leave as a friend. Peter's Tire and Auto Service, located at 135 North Water Street in downtown Yorksville. Peter's Tire and Auto is a full-service shop offering a wide range of automotive services and is a certified NAPA Auto Care Center. Allman Incorporated. You know them as A&M Service Center, located at 1172 Tuscarora's Avenue Northwest in New Philadelphia. Tis the season. If you know your car needs servicing soon, keep in mind our holiday hours. Schedule your appointment with A&M Service Center by calling 330-343-3013 this week to help you stay on schedule for your holiday travel. Twin City Pharmacy and Gift Shop, located at 21 Grant Street in Denison. Twin City Pharmacy and Gift Shop has been in existence for over 50 years, serving not only the needs of Denison and Yorksville customers, but customers from coast to coast. Open Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m., and Saturday, 9 a.m. to 3 p.m., and closed on Sundays.
And we're back as we go to the 106-pound match. Briar Cadle for Claymont and Caleb Robbins for New Philadelphia.
Nice single leg. Nice single leg there by Robbins.
So as we go into these last four matches, New Philadelphia still with a chance here, trailing 28-15. 2 points there for Briar Cadle. But what you know? What's your assessment of the next four matches?
Well, New Philly is about to go into the teeth of Claymont. Max Peters and Warners and Lane Peters are all outstanding wrestlers, of course. Excuse me. Tyler Warner, two-time state champ.
As you watch Cadle take advantage on the far side, trying to flip Robbins, and does. So they'll come back to the center of the mat. No score here on the 2-0 rather. Cato leading Robbins here in the 106-pound match. Minute 14 to go here in the first period of action.
He's got that cradle locked up again, and he knows how to pin with that. He's fighting. Robbins trying to fight that off. And he might squirm out of that. I don't know.
Yeah, it's going to be tough to get out of that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Pin for Briar Cadle. And that'll make it 34-15. Next match at 113, Max Peters for the Claymont Mustangs and Ryan Summers for the New Philadelphia Quakers.
Yeah, these next three weight classes for Claymont are probably three of their best wrestlers. So hopefully New Philly can get in there and compete and make something happen for them.
Quickly, Max Peters up 2-0.
Mm-hmm.
All righty, Peters is in the attack mode.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, he's got that half in awful tight, and that'll do it.
24 seconds. As that makes it 40-15. So now you go from the frying pan into the fire.
Yeah.
You've got the two-time state champion Tyler Warner next to 120 pounds taking on Neil Gibbs. And Gibbs has got to be coming out here thinking, uh-oh.
Yeah, I'm not sure what grade Gibbs is in, but this could be an awful tall order for him.
Quick two for Tyler Warner. Warner will let him go, making it 2-1. Two more for Tyler Warner, making it 4-1. And this could be over quickly the way it's looking right now.
He's got that cradle locked up. And that will probably about seal it.
So that pin took all of 50 seconds.
You know, one nice thing about that match, I mean, obviously, you know, Warner was much, much better, but he didn't go out there and showboat or embarrass him. He just went out there, took care of business. So good for Warner.
So the last match of the night will be Lane Peters for Claymont and L.J. Lowry for New Philadelphia. Two quickly for Lane Peters.
And he's got that cradle locked up, but he's going to run out of territory.
So we'll take it back to the center of the mat. We'll have a quick wrap-up brought to you by Bell Stores and our naming of our McDonald's MVP of the match coming up here shortly.
And another cradle. And that might close it up for Lowry. He's fighting, though.
Lowry's trying to fight it.
Yeah, he is.
Peters has got him down close. Minute 24. And in 37 seconds, the pin by Lane Peters. We'll come back. Wrap this match up for you here in a moment. 52-15, the final score. We'll be back with more in a moment from Claymont High School right here on TV2 Sports.
Government officials, business leaders, volunteers, and much more. You'll hear it all here on TV2 Profiles, exclusively on TV2. Hi, I'm your host, Cheyenne Carroll, and join me as I interview the Tuscarawas Valley's leading women. You can visit WJERTV2.com for show episodes and details.
In the nation, misfortune doesn't take a holiday. But add brand new belongings from Nationwide and we'll replace stolen or destroyed items with brand new versions. Making sure every season is the season of giving. Just another way we put members first. Join the nation.
Nationwide is on your side.
You can create a lasting legacy with a gift to the Tuscarawas County Community Foundation. It provides a safe, trustworthy, philanthropic choice for your estate planning needs. Through the generosity of area residents, the foundation has been able to provide nearly $5 million in funding for a variety of community projects and student scholarships that have positively impacted each corner of our county. Help your community by making a tax-deductible donation to the Tuscarawas County Community Foundation today.
Omni Orthopedics comprehensive programs provide early diagnosis
and successful treatment for every musculoskeletal problem. With more than 30 years of orthopedic experience, their physicians offer patient-centered treatment for all ages. From evaluation to rehabilitation, your treatment plan is designed around your needs. Omni Orthopedics specializes in sports medicine, the spine, physical medicine and rehabilitation, foot and ankle, and hand surgery. If pain makes activities like climbing stairs, standing or walking a challenge, turn to the home team at Omni Orthopedics. Their mission is to provide you with the highest quality and most advanced orthopedic services so you can get back in the game. Located in the Oxford Medical Arts Building, Omni offers a full-service facility, including digital x-ray and physical therapy. So there's no need to travel when quality care is so close to home. Omni Orthopedics, setting the standard in orthopedic care.
Hi, I'm Elaine Miller with Naturally Green Cleaning Service. My company serves both commercial and residential clients. We do general cleaning, spring and fall, empty homes to get them move-in ready, and final cleans for new construction. We use eco-friendly cleaning products that leave your home or office fresh, clean, and safe for you, your family, pets, or coworkers. Our focus at Naturally Green is to provide excellent customer service paired with outstanding work to build a relationship of trust with you, our clients. Having served the area 4+ years, we have had many referrals and testimonials that you can access on our website at www.naturallygreencs.com. Our work sells itself, therefore we have never had any contracts even with our largest commercial accounts. Call us today for your free quote and see what makes our company stand out.
To 15, the Claymont Mustangs handling the New Philadelphia Quakers in high school wrestling action. It's time now for our match wrap-up brought to you by Bell Stores with two new convenient locations to better serve you in Sugar Creek and Walnut Creek. Wrap up your day by stopping in at your convenient Bell Store and make sure your family's running on full. Really top to bottom, the Claymont Mustangs really dominant. New Philadelphia coming up with three victories in the match.
Yeah, Claymont just awful, you know, awful deep in their lineup. Very strong in their lightweights and hard for Philly to compete against those guys.
All right, that is our match wrap-up brought to you by Bell Stores with two new convenient locations to better serve you in Sugar Creek and Walnut Creek. Wrap up your day by stopping in at your local convenient Bell Store and make sure your family is running on full. It's time now for our MVP of the match brought to you by McDonald's with nine locations to serve you in Bolivar, Strasburg, Dover, Yorksville, Newcomerstown, Caddis, Sugar Creek, and two locations in New Philadelphia. A couple of great pins. We're going to move down the line to Lane Peters at 126, finishing up in style. 37 seconds to pin LJ Lowry, and Lane Peters is our McDonald's wrestler of the match. Brought to you tonight by McDonald's with nine locations to serve you in Bolivar, Strasburg, Dover, Yorksville, Newcomerstown, Caddis, Sugar Creek, and two locations in New Philadelphia. That's going to wrap it up here from Claymont High School. A wrestling victory for the Claymont Mustangs as they defeat New Philadelphia by a 52-15 score. For Rick Cole and the rest of our TV2 sports team, I'm Scott Robinson saying so long, everybody.